Hello, in this video you will learn about field area primitives. As in previous video we did outline primitives, now we have field area primitives. Outline primitives like point, line, line function, line drawing algorithms that we did in another video. Now we have field area primitives. Here first we will learn the basic. So first of all, what is polyline? That is the chain of connected line segments. So what is polyline? Chain of connected line segments. And what is line segment? That is the part of a line that is bounded by two distinct endpoints. Suppose we have two endpoints here. You can see when you will join these two endpoints, you can draw a line between these two endpoints. So we were talking about polyline. So what is polyline? Chain of connected line segments. You can see here, chain of connected line segments. You can see in this line we have two line segments. Now we will see the example of polyline, that is the chain of connected line segments. You can see here, this is polyline here. This is the starting point and this is the terminal point. And you can say these points are nodes or vertices, and we will denote all the nodes or vertices with P0, P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. Here P0 is the starting point, or you can say initial point. P5 is the terminal point, or you can say last point. So what is polyline? Chain of connected line segments. Done. Now what is polygon? That is the plane figure. You can describe it by finite number of straight line segments. When the starting point and the terminal point of any polyline is same, then it is called polygon. It means when the polyline is closed, then it is called polygon. When this point and this point for any figure is same, then you can call polygon. Let's see the example of polygon is here. You can see for all these figures, starting point and end point is same. Done. Here next is field area primitive. So first question is, what is region filling? That is the process of filling an area or image. So we have two approaches in order to fill area for any image. So you can use boundary filled region, or we have interior or flood filled region. So first we will learn about boundary filled region. Here, in order to fill the boundary, you can see here for this figure we have, this is the boundary. In order to fill the boundary, we will use boundary filling algorithms. And in order to fill the interior, suppose this is the figure and we want to fill this figure, so we will use flood fill algorithms in order to fill the interior portion of any figure or in this region. Now we have another question, how boundary filled algorithm works. Now next we will see how boundary filled algorithm works. So for this algorithm we need a seed. You can see here, we need a seed, or we will consider a seed that is nothing but just the starting pixel that you are going to consider. So first we will consider the starting pixel, that is seed. After that we will check the pixel boundary or the adjacent pixels are colored or not. That is, if the pixels are filled, they are already filled or colored, then leave it, else fill it. So how boundary fill algorithm works? First we will consider a seed. After that we will check the pixel boundary and the adjacent pixels that are filled or not. If the pixels are already colored, then leave it, else fill it. Now next question is, how to fill, how we can fill. So for this we will use again two approaches, 4 connected region and 8 connected region. We can use two approaches for the color filling, that is for 4 connected region and 8 connected region. Let's see what is 4 and 8 connected region. Here you can see here in this figure we have four connected regions. Here, this is the seed, and you can see here. Here, the seed is connected with four pixels, and here, this is the example of eight connected region. Here, the seed is connected with eight pixels. You can see here, 3, 6, 8, 7, 8. How we can fill? For the color filling, we can use two approaches, that is four connected region where the seed is connected with four pixels, and we have eight connected region where the seed or the starting pixel is connected with eight pixels. Now we will see next question is, as we are using here these approaches, how we will reach these pixels. Here we have a seed. Using this seed, we can fill the surrounded pixel. But question is here, how we will reach these pixels. So, in case of four connected region, every pixel can be reached by combination of moves in four directions. We have four directions, left, right, up and down, done. So we can reach all the pixels by a combination of moves in the different four directions. And in case of eight connected region, every pixel can be reached by a combination of moves in two horizontal, two vertical and four diagonal. Two horizontal, two vertical and four diagonal. Done. So what we did in this video, we were talking about filled area primitives. So first we did polyline, that is the chain of connected line segments. Here you can see two endpoints. When you will join these two endpoints, you can draw a line, and you can see the example of here line segments, that is the part of a line bounded by two distinct endpoints. And this is the example of polyline, that is the chain of connected line segments. This is the initial point, this is the endpoint, and here we have a polygon, that is nothing when the starting point and the end point of any polyline is same, then we can call it polygon. You can see here the example of polygon, the starting and the end point is same. Then we did the region filling, that is the process why you can fill area or image. So for this we have two approaches, boundary filled region and flood filled region. In boundary filled region, you can fill the boundary, and for this you will use boundary filling algorithms. For the interior filling, you will use flood fill algorithms in order to fill the region. Now we have boundary filling algorithm, how this works. First we will consider the seed, after that we will check the boundary. If it is already colored, then leave it, else fill it. Next question is how we can fill. So for this again we are using two approaches, four connected region and eight connected region. Here this is four connected region where the seed is connected with four pixels, and this is eight connected region where the seed is connected with eight pixels. So next is how we will reach these four pixels by a combination of moves in four directions, that is in left, right, up and down. And in case of eight connected region, you can reach all the pixel by moves in two horizontal, two vertical and four diagonal directions. So that's all about this video. In the next video we will do these algorithms using a numerical example how this algorithm is working. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching.